Good afternoon. As Executive Vice President and Provost, I declare the 2022 Winter Commencement Ceremony open and direct the academic procession to begin. Will the audience please rise?
Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome and thank you for being with us to celebrate the achievements of our graduates. Today we recognize some 300 students who will receive their degrees in their respective disciplines of study. To begin this morning's ceremony, please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem, led by Nathan Sekela, Mary Papert School of Music, class of 2023. Please remain standing for the opening prayer offered by Father Simon Adujamfi.
Twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air. Star-spangled banner yet wave. O'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Let us pray. Good and gracious God, as we gather here on this beautiful day and at this beautiful place, we thank you for the blessings we have received from you. We dedicate this celebration to you. May this graduation day be a celebration of your life within us. Send your Holy Spirit that gives life to us as we celebrate the achievement of your sons and daughters. For it is in you that we live and move and have our being. May they feel proud and enjoy celebrating their success. Father, bless Duquesne. Bless our students with whom we serve. Bless their families and friends. Bless these graduates. Fill them with the spirit of your love. Fill their minds with your thoughts. Fill their hearts with your dreams. We ask you, Lord, to restore and inspire them with your love. And as they journey through decisions about their work, homes, families, may they seek and find your guidance. Help them to use this qualification and knowledge to go out and bless the world. Fill them with gratitude, humility, love, and faith. Give them spiritual wisdom. Help them to hear your voice and inspire them to believe in the goodness of life, even when faced with challenges and difficulties. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
You may be seated. Commencement is one of the most important events of the academic year at Duquesne University. For our graduates, it signifies the completion of a significant period of work and study. At the same time, it is the beginning of the next stage of their lives. For some, in a profession or a career, while others continue their education in graduate school or schools of law or health professions. Whatever occupational, social, or educational challenges and opportunity you graduates encounter in the future. We are confident that you will be well prepared for them because of what you have learned at Duquesne, both in and out of the classroom. To all of our graduates today, we offer our congratulations and our best wishes for future success. In particular, the faculty, staff, and administration join with your parents, families, and friends in celebrating your accomplishments this day. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce to you the 13th president of Duquesne University, President Ken Gormley.
Thank you. Good morning, graduates, family, and friends. My name is Ken Gormley, and I have the privilege of serving as the 13th president of Duquesne University of the Holy Spirit. Graduates, you are about to join a family now of more than 100,000 Duquesne alumni who reside in all 50 states and more than 115 countries. From here, from this special university with more than a 144-year tradition, a tradition of excellence, you can go anywhere. From here, you will be able to embark on exciting paths and achieve great successes like generations of Duquesne graduates before you. I am thrilled to see with us today, along with our graduates, so many parents, grandparents, spouses, family members, significant others. As the father of two Duquesne graduates and a third, a daughter who's in graduate school here now, I understand the pride that all of you feel today. Thank you for entrusting your students to us and for giving them such valuable encouragement, love, and support. So first, before we go any further, I would like to ask the parents, grandparents, spouses, and significant others of our graduates to please stand. Okay, now hold it. I want you to stand. Now, graduates, you have permission to actually, you can stand up, you can do whatever. Find your family, wave, blow kisses, say I love you. This is a very special moment. I want you to remember it your whole lives. I think the parents and grandparents were more boisterous than the graduates this time. Good job. Here at Duquesne, we really do take seriously our personal approach to every student's education. Having spent much of my own career as a professor and a law school dean, I can attest that this is also a moment of great pride for our faculty, staff, and administrators. Could I ask all of them to please stand, faculty, staff, and administrators? Folks, these are the people who have guided, taught, and served each graduate throughout their time here. One of the great faculties in the United States of America. So, graduates, as December grads, the arrival of Christmas and New Year's now will be an annual reminder of this special moment when your Duquesne degree was officially conferred. For years to come, the holidays hopefully will be a time when that brings back memories of this moment, of this place, providing an opportunity to reflect not just upon this important milestone here today, but also, I hope, what earning these degrees really means. This is a true moment of celebration. You graduates of the class of 2022 have worked hard to get to this point. I know all too well you've weathered a pandemic. This has not been an easy time, but not only have you persevered, you are soared. And I have to say, it is so beautiful to see all of you here in person with your families. As we have gotten past those days. And so, as you mark this important high point in your journey, there really is a true sense of joy. This academic year, we have been relieved and grateful that your educational experience has been basically back to normal. And through it all, you have learned a great deal about what truly matters in life, including and especially the love and support of these families and friends and others, the meaningful relationships that you have formed here at Duquesne. And so as you move forward, I want to emphasize how important it is to remain grateful for these many blessings and to stay positive in your outlook each day. I can tell you that your sense of optimism will impact every aspect of your lives. It will enable you to make meaningful differences in the lives of others, while at the same time, you advance your own careers and your life goals. Today, I'm honored to begin this ceremony by presenting a special award that we only give out very, very rarely to a talented individual who has displayed an infectious positive outlook and who is revered for his countless contributions in music, culture, and education here on Duquesne's campus and in our city and truly across the world. This honoree is none other than Pittsburgh's native son, Joe Negri, a gifted musician who many of you know as Handyman Negri. How many of you remember Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood? Generations and generations of people, not just young people, but parents have been inspired by that television show. And as you can see, I think we have some pictures here, as you can see on the screen, Joe was cast as the proud owner of Negri's Music Shop on that show, which allowed for the introduction of a wide variety of musical guests. From Yo-Yo Mon to Wynton Marsalis and other stars, with Joe on guitar, Mr. McFeely there, right, Joe? And they would get together at WQED's studios right up the street in Oakland, often accompanied by Joe on guitar. Over the course of 35 years and more than 300 episodes, Joe taught generations of children to value music. Along with Fred Rogers, he also taught them to value kindness and to care for all of our neighbors. So let me tell you a little bit about, there's King Friday, tell you a little bit about Joe Negri, who was an integral part of Pittsburgh's music scene even before his celebrated role on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. When he was just 4 years old, Joe started performing in theatrical and radio productions, first on a ukulele and later on guitar. He was quickly discovered as a child guitar prodigy. So when he was just 16, he went on the road with famous bandleader Shep Fields, performing in Chicago, New York, and other destinations. He served in the Army, then returned to Pittsburgh, where he formed the popular Joe Negri Trio and studied composition at Carnegie Tech, now Carnegie Mellon University, led a live jazz trio on KDKA-TV, and served as musical director at WTAE-TV for decades, producing and performing on several award-winning television programs. So Joe met Mr. Rogers in the mid-1960s, and they became fast friends and collaborators, working on some shows that a few of you parents and grandparents may remember, Ricky and Copper and Paul Shannon's Adventure Time. I was actually on that when I was about 10 years old. So when Fred Rogers conceived of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, that's when Handyman Joe was born, Handyman Negri. Throughout it all, Joe has continued to perform and compose, and today at a sprightly young age of 96, he remains one of the most recognized names in Pittsburgh music circles, but he is also viewed as truly one of the finest jazz guitarists in the country and has performed alongside a host of renowned performers. Most recently, he was a guest with the Pittsburgh Symphony Orchestra, was featured on PSO's Sony Music Cinema Serenade, has recorded with giants in the music industry. He has also distinguished himself as a composer, earning critical acclaim. And for our purposes, the most special part is he shared these skills, these talents, with many, many Duquesne students, faculty, and alumni of our music program. In fact, Joe has uplifted and inspired generations of music students here at Duquesne's Mary Papert School of Music, where he founded a highly respected jazz guitar studies program in 1973 that is still going strong a half century later. He also served as chair of our jazz guitar department, contributed to the university as an adjunct professor of music for nearly 50 years. Additionally, Joe has been a special guest performer at numerous events on campus, including my own inauguration back in 2016. That was the high point, Joe, for me, of the inauguration. It was also, there's a picture of it up there, Joe. It was also wonderful to have Joe join us in 2018 with Fred Rogers' late wife, the wonderful Joanne Rogers, for a special tribute to Fred's life, along with his biographer, Max King. That was a fun picture from that. Joe has received numerous awards and honors throughout the years, including Man of the Year from the Pittsburgh Cultural Trust, the Mellon Jazz Community Award, and the Hillman Foundation's coveted ELSI Award. He also received an honorary Doctor of Music degree from Duquesne in 2004. So today, to mark this special commencement, and to I am honored to recognize Joe's selfless desire to share his talents as a musician, educator, and mentor by presenting to him a special presidential medal, because he is truly a historic figure who has shaped both Duquesne and the world for the better. But before I present this special award, I wanted to just show you a very brief video clip that showcases Joe's skill on the guitar as he plays a tune for Fred Rogers, one of Mr. Rogers' favorites, and it's particularly fitting for today's ceremony because it's called You Are Special. So let's take a look.
I was just singing, You Are My Friend, You Are Special. I'd like my friends to hear the way you might.
I'd like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my great honor to bestow this elite award on our honoree who truly is special. It's my distinct privilege today to confer the Presidential Award for Extraordinary Service to Duquesne University and the community upon a wonderful human being and an insightful teacher whose life's work has truly demonstrated a love of community and a compassion for others. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in recognizing and expressing our gratitude to Mr. Joe Negri. Okay, we're going to ask Joe to say a few words here. What do you think, Joe?
Yeah.
Can I say a couple words?
You may, please, please.
Oh, President Gormley, God love you. Thank you so much. And thank all of you. I'm overwhelmed, honored, and humbled. And I'm really very, very happy to be here today. You know, I just wanted to say one thing. When I started with the guitar and education kind of went their own separate ways, you know. I couldn't get into guitar in high school. I couldn't get into jazz guitar in college. So I just kept going. And finally in 1970, Duquesne called me and said, would you come down and start a guitar school and teaching jazz guitar? And that was it. And before you knew it, it was like a couple of years, and we had four teachers. Mr. Bill Peirce was one of them. And it just was wonderful. It grew and it grew and it grew. So I'm honored. Thank you very much.
Okay, so here, I'm gonna take the, I guess this won't come on. Okay, so to celebrate the deep sense of community and pride that we feel today, I'm going to ask everyone to join us in singing a favorite tune from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, one that reflects, I think, the positivity that we're all feeling today, especially these members of the class of 2022. Yeah. And the song is, It's Such a Good Feeling. So what could be more fitting for this class that has weathered pandemics and challenges and everything else to reach this milestone today? So we do have as our accompanist Professor Bill Peirce from the Mary Papert School of Music. He was one of the first jazz majors at Duquesne who studied under this guy here, under Joe Negru. Mm-hmm. So Joe is going to join me in singing this song along with all of you in our audience and our students. And to make it easy, the words are going to be on the big screen. And I also have them right here, Joe, so we can't forget anything.
It's a good feeling.
Yeah, well, I know that you know it, too. So, Bill, we're going to ask you to tee it up with the first few words, and then Joe and I and the audience are going to jump in. Joe, your voice is better than mine, so I'm going to get you closer.
No, your voice is terrific.
Okay, Bill, take it.
It's been, you ready here? You got the key? Okay. It's such a good feeling to know you're alive. It's such a happy feeling to
you're growing inside.
And when you wake up ready to say,
I think I'll make a snappy new day.
It's such a good feeling. A very good feeling, a good feeling, you know, that I'm okay.
I love you, thank you.
And I'll be back when the day is new, and I'll have lots of ideas for you, and you'll have things you want to talk about. And I
will do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Joe Negri, recipient of this
Gracias. Thank you all. All the best of luck to you people back there. I hope your life is beautiful, healthy, and you get to do what you want to do.
Okay, stay here 1 second before you let you go. He has a family obligation, but graduates, we're looking forward to seeing what is next for each of you as you transform the world, just like Joe Negri has done through your own knowledge, skills, compassion, core values, civility, and faith. And as we get ready to move on to the main event of this ceremony, which is, of course, the conferral of degrees, let me offer one final observation. To all of you family and friends here in the audience, I can tell you this is a great group of graduates. I know this class of 2022. They reflect the very best qualities of this special university. From this class, leaders will emerge, individuals who will accomplish amazing things that we will be talking about and writing about for decades to come as the new history of Duquesne is written. And so on behalf of the whole Duquesne community and more than 100,000 alumni whose ranks you will now join, I can only say we are incredibly proud of all of you, and congratulations. I hope there is plenty of time to celebrate this singular achievement, not just today, but in the weeks ahead. Have a beautiful Christmas, a wonderful holiday season with your families, and from me and Joe, God bless.
Thank you. Thank you, Tim. We'll have to see each other.
Yes, we will.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Let's now begin the part of the ceremony that you've been waiting for, the presentation of our graduating students. To begin the presentation of diplomas, I'm pleased to invite Dean Christine Blair of the McAnulty College and Graduate School of Liberal Arts to come forward. Chris.
Mr. President, as Dean of the McAnulty College and Graduate School of Liberal Arts, I present the students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present to them the degrees they have earned? John Mitchum, Chair of the History Department, will announce the students.
Hannah Marie Abercrombie. Bailey M. Balcar. Alicia B. Ballantyne Dye. Edward Allen Bartley. Sydney Carolyn Boss, cum laude. Skylar M. Brown, cum laude. Emily Corinne Bruzeski, magna cum laude. Braylon Elizabeth Bruno, summa cum laude. Rennie Christopher Kabakunga, summa cum laude. Anna Louise Courtney. Jacqueline Ray Croissant. Emily Elizabeth Dodd, cum laude. Q. Kira Sophia Curtis. Brittany Jane Diobilda, summa cum laude. Kevin Michael Easley, Jr. Maximilian Anthony Engel. Rosemary Kishana Grant. Jack Charles Hamill, magna cum laude. Raymond Sorrell Hart, Jr. Ethan Joshua Horn,
I said
magna
to Ramon,
cum laude.
I'm afraid to think what happens when he gets a law degree next.
Ethan Joshua Horn, magna cum laude. Simon M. Jaronsky, summa cum laude. Cameron Brooke Johnston, cum laude. Jonathan Douglas Christoph. Alexa M. Kribble. Caroline T. Kutchko, magna cum laude. Ava Rose Kunkel. John Michael Lenoski. Timothy B. Lowry, Jr. Vincent Russell Lumia. Chloe Elizabeth Manupelli, summa cum laude. Shea Gerard McTighe. Rachel Liana Means, summa cum laude. Caitlin E. Miller. Logan Thomas Muck. Maya D. Nurianan. Kendall Adriana Nasadku, magna cum laude. Rebecca Sharon Nelson. Danielle Newell Settles. Grace Nicole Oakes. Nathan Wendell Proctor, Jr. Ashley J. Rodriguez. Garrett Arthur Rosa. Alexandra Miriam Ross. Alexander Joseph Sheets. Patrick William Schiappani, cum laude. Erin Elizabeth Schlenk, cum laude. Rachel Claire Schmidt. Angela G. Sereo, cum laude. Aaron Courtney Sheckard. Cambry Jensen Short, magna cum laude. Sarah Ann Skibu, magna cum laude. Amari Brianna Smith. Alexis Lindsay Stample, cum laude. Malik Strozier. Lydia E. Troutman, magna cum laude. Samantha M. Vale, magna cum laude. Jay Vance. Renee Monique Waklatsky. James George Walsh. Sarah Jane Weisel. Brentaro Kenneth Yamani. The candidate for the Bachelor of Science degree, Anthony Francis Vagni. Candidates for the Master of Arts degree, Muniru Abdulrahman Ala Ajalan. Hamed Awasadi. Clinton Mario Ehibor. Caitlin Alexandra Harris. Margaret Jean Portman. Tammy L. Proctor. Avery Emma Sandy Wares. Candidates for the Master of Fine Arts degree, Shimung Chin. Candidates for the Master of Science degree, Timothy Michael Baker. Jolisa Leslie McDonald. Denise N. Mitchell. Devin Tyler Myers. Ryan Tashad Webb. Candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy degree, Lucas Earl Chandler, Hood presenter Dr. Gerald McGill. Austin D. Hesterlin, Hood presenter, Dr. Eric Garrett. Ayub Mampela, Hood presenter, Dr. Janie Harden Fritz. Joseph D. Smith, Hood presenter, Dr. William Wright.
I now invite Dr. Dean McFarlane, Dean of the Palumbo School of Business Administration and the John F. Donahue Graduate School of Business to come forward.
Mr. President, as Dean of the Palumbo School of Business Administration and the John F. Donahue Graduate School of Business, I present the students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present to them the degrees they have earned? Dr. Matt Drake, Associate Professor of Supply Chain Management, will announce the students.
The candidates for the Bachelor of Science in Business Administration degree are Keyshawn T. Adams. Katie Ann Alice, cum laude. Benjamin Stafford Arnold. Shane Thomas Bauer. Brandon Alexander Borick. Jack T. Breen, cum laude. Cameron R. Bush. Gregory Michael Calvin. Nigel Everton Carr. Andrew Paul Chopka, cum laude. Isabel Marie Clark, cum laude. Nicole Costa. Alexander C. D'Razio, magna cum laude. Keaton Abigail Engel, cum laude. Anthony John Regala Evanoff. Madeline Taylor Fluss, magna cum laude. Abigail Lynn Garman. Kylie Renee Garver. Kira Lee Golden, cum laude. Brandon L. Gregg. Kyle Patrick Grimm. Luke Edward Jang Harada. Kevin Michael Kamick. Roberto Alexander Laporte Jr. Jared Lichtenwalter. Isabella Louise Mazziotti. Meredith Grace McGinley. Kevin Patrick McHale. Hunter James Mueller, cum laude. Troy Anthony Neely. Brennan Paul Neidhart. Nicole Marie Park, magna cum laude. Landon Lee Pringle. Madhav Agnesh Purohit, cum laude. Alexander James Quinn. Julian Cotis Rao, standing proudly with his father, Dr. Stephen Rao, cum laude. Jack A. Redder, magna cum laude. Nicholas P. Rosner, cum laude. Katie Maureen Ryan, cum laude. Elizabeth Marie Sklodowski, magna cum laude. Ian James Smith, magna cum laude. Caitlin Elizabeth Swiger, magna cum laude. Ian Jacob Taylor, cum laude. Joao Gabriel Valenti. Tianye Chui. Changbin Yuan, cum laude.
Big Smith!
The candidates for the Master of Business Administration degree are Megan Catherine Oren, graduating with high honors. Carrie Lynn Boffman, graduating with honors. Janetta Beckman, graduating with high honors. Richard Giovanni Del Prado. Elizabeth Catherine Galloway, graduating with honors. Luke G. Hollander, graduating with honors. Alicia Lynn Herney. Tanya Brene Johnson, graduating with honors. Richard Joseph Lavery, graduating with honors, also earning a post-baccalaureate certificate in entrepreneurship. Mario Stephen Lombardi. Nicholas James Notto. Christabel Offe, also earning post-baccalaureate certificate in supply chain management. Favor Ofori Achampong. Mary Therese Olson, graduating with high honors. Thomas Henry Richards. Vijayan Sabapathy. Nicole Elizabeth Sisk. Lila Joy Thompson. Candidates for the Master of Science degree are Philip George Dowie, major in Analytics and Information Management, graduating with highest honors. Nathan Faila, major in Analytics and Information Management. Joseph Anthony Frangioni, major in Analytics and Information Management, graduating with high honors. George Stewart Hill, major in Management, graduating with honors. Sahithi Kankapati, major in Analytics and Information Management. Lacey Marie Scott Jones, major in Management, also earning a post-baccalaureate certificate in entrepreneurship. Vivek Venkatesh Shanbag, major in Analytics and Information Management, graduating with highest honors. Jawahar Tripathi, major in Analytics and Information Management, graduating with honors. Jema Ann Wise, major in Analytics and Information Management, graduating with highest honors. Purva Kushgar, major in Analytics and Information Management, graduating with high honors.
I now invite Dr. James Drennan, Dean of the School of Pharmacy, to come forward.
Mr. President, as Dean of the School of Pharmacy, I present the students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present to them the degrees they have earned? Dr. Carl Anderson, Associate Dean for Research and Graduate Programs, will announce the students.
Will the candidate for the degree Bachelor of Science in Pharmaceutical Sciences please come forward? Ryan Taylor.
I now invite Dean David Allen Ware of the Mary Papert School of Music to come forward.
Mr. President, as Dean of the Mary Papert School of Music, I present the students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present to them the degrees that they have earned? Dr. Rachel Whitcomb, Associate Dean, will announce the students.
Yishi Zhang, Bachelor of Music and Performance, magna cum laude. Adrian Rose Kessler, summa cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Music Education. Kirsten Lane Stauffer, magna cum laude, Bachelor of Science in Music Education and Bachelor of Music in Performance. Megan Jo Dell, summa cum laude, Bachelor of Arts in Music. Logan J. Murphy, Bachelor of Arts in Music. Donald P. White III, Bachelor of Arts in Music. Yaping Tang, Master of Music in Performance.
I now invite Dean Gretchen Jenneret, Dean of the School of Education, to come forward.
Mr. President, as Dean of the School of Education, I present the students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present to them the degrees they have earned? Dr. Julia Williams will present the undergraduate students, and Dr. Fran Sarenka will announce the graduate students.
Emily Dazelle, the first to complete the Equity Education Certification Program. Emily Elizabeth Dodd. Claire Roseanne Farrell. Olivia Humphrey. Alexa M. Kriebel, magna cum laude. Mira Steen, cum laude. James George Walsh. William Wallace Weber. William.
For the degree Master of Science in Education, Jean Carlos Frias Vergara. Ibtizam Saad Al Rafi. Angelina Marie Hernley. Mashkura Mukhidinova. Isaiah James Nanny. Deanna Lauren Stammer. Natalia A. Steen. For the degree Master of Science, Anna Marie Edwards. Alexis Reed Contos. Sydney Caroline Maurer. Darian D. Reynolds. Katie Ann Goodman Tercine. For the degree Doctor of Education, Lisa Carton Beaulieu Hood, presented by Dr. Joseph Cush. Stephanie Lynn Graben, hooded by Dr. Joseph Cush. Rachel Ann Gediminskas Calberer. Brinley Marie Kantorski, hood presented by Dr. John Pollock. Jamar J. King, hood presented by Dr. Rick McGowan. Casey Margaret O'Donnell Chavis, hood presented by Dr. Gibbs Kenyongo. Cheryl Farron Tax, hood presented by Dr. Misuk He. Shungnan Ye, hood presented by Gibbs Kenyongo. For the degree Doctor of Psychology, Jessica Elizabeth Case, hood presented by Dr. Jessica Dersmith. Casey Hauser, hood presented by Dr. Tammy Hughes. Paxton Shayna Lawley, hood presented by Dr. Kara McGoey. For the degree Doctor of Philosophy, Shadi Ahmad Al-Badawi, hood presented by Dr. Bridget Green. Mroom Muhammad Al-Nahari, hood presented by Dr. Anna Huang. Courtney Lynn Chalecki, hood presented by Dr. Elizabeth McCallum. Krissa Ann Franzetta, hood presented by Dr. Anna Huang. Zachary A. Friedman, hood presented by Dr. Tammy Hughes. Sylvester Sharon Kanner, hood presented by Dr. Judith Griggs. Kristen Elizabeth Mahoney, hood presented by Dr. Elizabeth McCallum. Monica L. Patillo, hood presented by Dr. Jarrett Colbert. Felicity Ariel Rodriguez, hood presented by Dr. Matthew Joseph. Michael Sickles, hood presented by Dr. Jared Colbert.
I now invite Dr. Mary Ellen Glasgow, Dean of the School of Nursing, to come forward.
Mr. President, as Dean of the School of Nursing, I present students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present to them the degrees they have earned? Dr. Rebecca Kronk, Associate Dean for Academic Affairs, will announce the students.
Degrees for the Bachelors of Science, Haley P. Elmacy. Haley Kristen Sasser. Michaela Hope Creel. Abby Lynn Chufi. Ashley Elizabeth Diaz. Kaya Yvette Epsley. Carly Jean Fredericks. Caitlin Elizabeth Goodman. Kayla Rachel Goodman. Grace Tasia Hanlon. Bridget Gal Hennessy. Grace Karen Hoffer. Ivy Wakio Mwakago. Christopher Stephen Perry. Manjot Kaur Saini. Margot Elise Todd. The Master of Science in Nursing, Jareen Lean Bobitsky. Karen Denise Bradley. Catherine V. Clark. Rachel Christine Costa. Megan Brinson Daniels. Natalie Kirsten Fortna Fox. Amanda Jo Frank. Erin Christine Harris. Brandy Suzanne Joyce. Mary Elizabeth Nasser. Emily Cianol Ralston. Alexis Seligman. Gabrielle Nicole Slane. Sharon Sabatino Stewart. Brittany Elizabeth Thornton. Mackenzie S. Trader. Elena Catherine Webb. The Doctor of Nursing Practice. Janet Amerike Nguyen. She will be hooded by Dr. Mary Kay Loughran. Kirsten Burt. She will also be hooded by Dr. Mary Kay Loughran. Stephanie Ann DeSilvio, hooded presentation by Dr. Frank Kosnowski. Susan Sakura Ekman, hood presentation by Dr. Frank Kosnowski. Jenai Silas Grundy, hood presentation by Dr. Mary Kay Loughran. Kelly Lynn Llewellyn, hood presentation by Dr. Frank Kosnowski. Sinanibe Patrick Moniki, hood presentation by Dr. Frank Kosnowski. Aww. Tammy Marie Schwab, hood presentation by Mangelotta Avott. Annetta Lynn Sipes, hood presentation by Dr. Mangelotta Avott. Gina S. Williams, hood presentation by Dr. Mangelotta Avott. Candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy in Nursing. Carla Renee Adu, hood presentation by Dr. Rick Zuha. Jaina Mosiri Brooks, hood presentation by Dr. Linda Garand. Natalie Eve Veronique Confiak, hood presentation by Dr. Melanie Turk. Kelly Ann Filchner, hood presentation by Dr. Rick Zuha. Rashida L. Henderson, hood presentation by Dr. Rick Zuha. Abigail Ruth Croft Friedman, hood presentation by Dr. Kathleen Sokola. Karen Elizabeth Robson, hood presentation by Dr. Linda Garand.
Safe trip.
Teresa Ryan Schultz, hood presentation by Dr. Rick Zuha. Jennifer May Stephen, hood presentation by Dr. Rick Zuha.
I now invite Dr. Fevzi Akinsi, Dean of the John G. Rango Senior School of Health Sciences, to come forward.
Mr. President, as Dean of the John G. Rango Senior School of Health Sciences, I present the students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present to them the degrees they have earned. Dr. Elizabeth Diolis, Clinical Associate Professor, will announce the students.
I present to you the Master of Health Administration candidates, Sydney Jean Kessler. Megan Julia Ott. Now I present to you the Master of Speech Language Pathology candidate, Hai To Su. I present to you the Master of Science in Occupational Therapy candidates, Michaela Rose Crawford. Claire Ann Velasco. Emily Rose Hall. Melissa Sue Nafziger. Carissa A. Pegg. Sarah Ann Rafasco. I present to you the Occupational Therapy Doctorate candidates. Sudhi Acharya, hooded by Dr. Retta Martin. Delaney Catherine Batik, hooded by Dr. Michelle McCann. Julia Nicole Bersani, hooded by Dr. Amy Madela.
Olivia Noel Borovich, hooded by Dr. Elizabeth DeYolius.
Lindsay Jane Brand, hooded by Dr. Ashlyn Gupner. Jamie N. Foster, hooded by Dr. Ann Stewart. Stephanie Bernadette Galasso, hooded by Dr. Gerald Benson. Emily Caitlin Georgia, hooded by Dr. Ann Stewart. Caitlin Rose Hallahan, hooded by Dr. Richard Simpson. Molly McHugh Heinz, hooded by Dr. Elena Donoso Brown. Yeah. Jackson Dudley Johnson, hooded by Dr. Megan Blaskowitz. Nicole Caitlin Jones, hooded by Dr. Michelle McCann. McKenna Mary Killian, hooded by Dr. Megan Blaskowitz. Rebecca Marie LaCroix, hooded by Dr. Amy Madela. Emma Morgan McCleary, hooded by Dr. Elena Donoso Brown. Sarah Catherine McDonald, hooded by Dr. Elizabeth Diolis. Emma Suzanne Nagler, hooded by Dr. Megan Blaskowitz. Gabriella R. Santa Cecilia, hooded by Dr. Ashlyn Gupner. Yeah. Olivia K. Shope, hooded by Dr. Richard Simpson. Emily Marie Weingartner, hooded by Dr. Gerald Benson. I present to you the Doctor of Physical Therapy candidate, Elena Christine Copenhaver, hooded by Dr. David Kleba. Please join me in congratulating our graduates.
I now invite Dr. Ellen Gewalt, Dean of the Bayer School of Natural and Environmental Sciences, to come forward.
Mr. President, as Dean of the Bayer School of Natural and Environmental Sciences, I present the students who have completed their academic curricula and are entitled to recognition. Will you please present them the degrees to which they have earned? Dr. Mihalescu, Interim Chair and Professor of Chemistry and Biochemistry, will announce the names.
candidates for the Bachelor of Science degree. Ariana Marie Caroon. Thomas P. Connor. Allison Fry, magna cum laude. Gabrielle Ann Geinzer, cum laude. Lindsay Paige Immler. Rebecca Sharon Nelson. Hannah Elizabeth Rowe. Andrew Lawler Stark. Mirabella B. Stump. Candidates for the Bachelor of Arts degree. Alexander Joseph Sheets. Candidates for the Master of Science in Environmental Science and Management. Nicole Erica Dugan. Calvin James Fagans, Jr. Candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy degree. Ashley Nicole Ebert, hooded by Dean Ellen Gewalt. Christina Lynn Grugan, hooded by Dr. David Lampe. Mark Augustine Resnick, hooded by Dr. Jeffrey Evansek.
Get in the picture.
Angel Tamez, hooded by Dr. Jeffrey Evansek.
Okay, now, will all of the candidates for degrees please rise? I think this is the moment we've been waiting for. Please rise. Come on. Hold it. No applause yet. Hold it. As president of Duquesne University of the Holy Spirit, and by the authority vested in me by the University Board of Directors and by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I hereby confer upon you the degrees you have earned with all of the rights, privileges, and obligations pertaining thereto. Congratulations, it is official, the class of 2022, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for them. Yeah, they can have a standing ovation. Come on.
You may now be seated. Congratulations again, graduates. At this time, I would like to acknowledge the other distinguished members of the platform party who are with us this morning. Please stand up as I call your name. Mr. Charles Bartlett, Vice President for Information Technology and Chief Information Officer. Mr. Joel Bauman, Senior Vice President for Enrollment Management. Ms. Pamela Conley, Senior Vice President for Legal Affairs and General Counsel. Father John Fogarty, Senior Advisor to the President for Spirit and Mission and Campus Culture. Father Raymond French, Senior Vice President for Mission and Identity. Dr. Matthew J. Frist, Senior Vice President for Finance and Business. Dr. Douglas Frizzell, Vice President for Student Life. Mr. William Jenrett, Senior Vice President of Civic Engagement and External Relations. Dr. John Kaufman, Dean of the proposed College of Osteopathic Medicine. Dr. Kathleen Sekula, President of the Duquesne University Faculty Senate. Dr. Kimberly Horitz, University Registrar. Ms. Crystal McCormick-Ware, Chief Diversity Officer and Senior Advisor to the President for Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. Father John A. Sawicki, Member of the Corporation and Board of Directors. Mr. Gabriel Welsh, Vice President for Marketing and Communications. Ladies and gentlemen, to introduce a special rendition of the Duquesne University alma mater, please welcome the Dean of our Mary Papert School of Music again to the stage, Dr. David Allen Ware. Following Dean Ware's remarks and the singing of the alma mater, Father Simon Adejamfi will offer a blessing.
A group of Spiritan priests landed in Pittsburgh 150 years ago and in a few short years founded what would become Duquesne University. As part of marking the anniversary of their arrival, President Ken Gormley had the vision to refresh the university's original alma mater for a new era with beautiful words and music inspired by the original. President Gormley wanted both words and music infused with echoes of the original, which was in part written by the Spiritan Reverend John F. Malloy in 1920. He asked that the music be created by one of our many talented composers at the Mary Papert School of Music, composition area coordinator Robert Traw. President Gormley, himself an accomplished writer, wrote the lyrics. The two have been collaborating over the last few months with help and input from recent alums and friends. The refreshed alma mater premiered at our Mary Papert School of Music Christmas concert just a few weeks ago. And today, we are pleased to perform it for the first time as a part of a Duquesne University commencement ceremony as we mark this special 150th anniversary. I am pleased to introduce Nathan Sekela, a music performance major in the Mary Papert School of Music. Nathan will sing the refreshed alma mater once as a solo performance, and then we invite you all to join along. The words are in the program and will also appear on the big screens throughout the field house.
Let us pray. Almighty God, our source of light, we started this celebration with you and we are closing it with you. And so we come before you once again with humble hearts, thanking you for the wonderful things we have achieved and received from you. As we leave this place, Lord, surround us with your love. May we feel your love and know your wisdom and experience your power. May your mighty hand be upon our graduates as we send them forward. May your spirit guide them as they unfold the next chapters of their lives. May they find the comfort they desire in you and the strength they need in your name. May your presence be with them every hour of the day. May your love be the passion in their hearts. May your joy be their strength when times are hard. Fill them with your spirit. May they be full of your grace, joy, and peace. Help them to imitate you by serving the poor, the needy, and the afflicted. May your angels go before them and clear the way for them. For this is the day that you have made, and we are glad and rejoice in it. And so I invite you all to raise your hands on our graduates as they receive blessings. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. Amen. As you run the race of this present life, may God make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity. Amen. May the Lord hold you in the palm of his hands, and may your dreams ever be fulfilled. Amen. And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Father. And now there is one final order of business. Some of these graduates told me they wanted to throw their caps in the air. So now if it's attached to your head, you don't have to do it. But if you're ready, let's do it on the count of three. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, throw. Congratulations, Duquesne University class of 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2022.
As the ceremony closes, I ask that the audience remain at their seats during the recession. I now declare the 2022 Winter Commencement Ceremony closed and request that the President's Party follow me and the University of City Mace from the stage.